The election is literally days away. It's anyone's race. And to be perfectly honest, I'm scared.
A new poll says Donald Trump has taken a slight lead over Hillary Clinton for the first time.
With the White House at stake, the Democrats are pulling out the big guns. And it doesn't get much bigger than First Lady Michelle Obama.
You're terrified, aren't you?
I am.
Of the prospects of waking up on November the 9th to a candidate who is not the best to run this country. But here's the thing, Angelique. We are in full control of this. You know, this is an election that if we turn out, and by we, I'm meaning minorities, young folks, women, if we turn out in the same way that we did in 2008 and 2012, Hillary Clinton will win.
Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States.
Blacks, Hispanics, Muslims, females, we can all imagine what a Trump White House looks like. Mm-hmm. Will you share what Secretary Clinton's plan is to preserve and enhance the change that President Obama has started?
She and her husband were among the first administrations to try to pass affordable health care.
Mm-hmm.
Barack was able to get it done. So they're going to continue to do the work to strengthen that legislation and to make sure that people continue to have health care. To make sure that women have access to birth control. She's going to keep cutting taxes for working class families. And Hillary's going to finish the job that Barack started.
9 years ago, many felt young Barack Obama didn't have the experience to lead this country. Some of those same people are supporting Donald Trump, who has no political experience. I talked to TV journalist Roland Martin of News One Now. How does this happen?
Well, it's real easy. You got here because Republicans cultivated this anger, this resentment against Democrats, against President Obama, against Hillary Clinton. You invited evil into your home, and now evil has consumed you.
Well, I'm scared.
Well, you can't be scared. You can't be scared. What has to happen is we got to have folks not sitting their butts on the sidelines. I had all kinds of people who complained to me in 2009, 2010 of the Tea Party. I can't get mad at the Tea Party. I said, you know why? Because they're out there protesting. They're out there mobilizing and organizing.
I thought electing our first black president meant our nation had evolved. But this election has proven otherwise.
I don't think there was any racism until Obama got elected. And if you're black and you haven't been successful in the last 50 years, it's your own fault. I mean, when do they take responsibility for how they live? I think it's due time, and I think that's good that Mr. Trump is pointing that out.
I've done my part. I've done shows, segments, interviews, encouraging people to vote. I've read all the propositions, filled out my ballot, mailed it in. Now, all any of us can do is wait.
The world leaders know that the United States needs a competent commander-in-chief who knows what they're doing. And the only person in this race who fits that bill is Hillary Clinton. That's why we're supporting her. That's why I've been so passionately out there, Angelique, because I know that we need this woman in the White House. And if I didn't believe it, I wouldn't be on this phone making this phone call with you right now.
For Annenberg Media, I'm Angelique Perrin.